So when I grew up, the whole island, the population was around 600, which was a lot. And just in my grade, my age alone, I had 26 in my class, just my age. Now the school, from pre-K through the sixth grade, has seven children total, not per grade, total. And four of those is from down here, from Tylerton. So the population is somewhere around 250, 60, something like that, as opposed to 600 or some. Used to be big families. And most of them, I bet half of them, from when I moved down here to Tylerton, moved to the mainland. And then their children moved. So see, you lose all them generations of children. And the children has children. They marry and they have children. So now, if they marry, most time they'll find somebody off island and they'll make their homes, somewhere else. So it's, I guess we're the last generation. This winter, when my neighbor leaves to go to Chrisville, that's Hester. I'll be the oldest woman, and Dwight will be the oldest man on Tylerton. It looks like to me, if we don't get some babies born, and the older people pass away, I don't see that the generations can carry on the church, the fire company, the store, the schools, even the post office. There are five main things that, like any other little community, how will they exist without the revenues? They won't at all. These waters in the Chesapeake Bay have supplied throughout the generations for hundreds of years, meals on the table, money to pay the bills and all that. But there's going to be no watermen to harvest anymore. So we're not going to only be the losers. I'll probably be dead and gone before Smith Island closes down. But you people that enjoy eating the crab meat and the soft crabs and the hard Jimmy crabs and the beautiful fish fillets and all, there's going to be nobody in to catch them to feed you bunch either. It's not only it's going to be in a lost art, what it's going to be. And this is not only for our island, but it's Deal Island, Tangier Island, Hooper's Island, all the watermen's, villages around us. It's a serious problem. I don't know how much longer we'll exist. I bet we won't go to more than 10 or 15 years, if that. And then the product, the men don't get a whole lot for their crabs. Right now, I don't know what you pay for hard crabs in the city, but my husband's getting $40 a bushel for males. A bushel of big, and they have got to be 5 3/4 inches and up. That's a big crab. And they're gorgeous crabs. And they're getting $40, hardly enough to even pay for the fish bait that they use in their pots. So when your expense is greater than your profit, that's not good either.